Hey everyone, in today's Mac tip, I'm going to show you a little bit about how to keep your applications updated on your Mac. Now, most people know to keep your apps from the App Store updated on your Mac, you would go under the Apple menu, click on App Store, go to the Updates tab, and click Update All or Update Individual in order to keep the apps from the App Store updated. But what do you do about all the other applications you have that don't exist in the App Store? So, which utilities do you use and what is the best one out there? Well, I personally use Mac Update and I've tried a lot of them. This one has kind of the third generation because they used to have an older version of it, but the one that they have now is terrific and I use it all the time. Now, let's take a look at it and see what it does. First of all, it has this little utility in the desktop area where you can actually open up the app directly, which shows you all the applications that you have, what installed version you have. So this is the version you have installed on your computer. What's the current version? And then you can just simply click on it, as I've done here with Google Chrome, and click to do an update. So here, if I was doing it with Microsoft Word and I would click on it, it would download it and would do an update. So let's pick one here. Let's do Onyx and I'm going to click update. And there it goes. It's just going to update it directly from the computer, which is really cool. Now, when it's done, it's going to obviously finish with the bar over here and it will do a complete install. And it's basically a one-click install. What's also nice is that you could actually do this from the desktop area. And you could see that Onyx is trying to be updated over here. And then you could see all these other updates. You can either update all of them, or you could check for new updates. You could launch the desktop, which is this version in the background, or you can quit the desktop or even open up the app just to make sure that everything's okay. But this gives you a full list, and it's pretty cool because it actually shows what you need to update and what you don't, and then you can make your choices. And you probably half of these wouldn't even know that these have to be upgraded if you didn't do it. And if in the middle you want to stop it, there's a little handy little thing over here that you can click to stop it. But that's fully loaded, as you could see. And if we want to click on open, we can check out that application to open it. So basically, if you have applications on your Mac that are not all in the App Store, which most people do, you could also click the Update All, and you know you have 27 updated apps that you have to update, which is a really cool and easy way. Now, it's very hard to know which of these applications work because a lot of them out there are kind of like not 100%, where it's really doing what you want it to do. This one actually does what you want it to do. I could recommend it. It's not downloading some weird stuff to your computer that you're going to need, have a bunch of adware on it. So I would recommend this one. I use this a lot. It's really easy, and I mainly don't even open up the desktop. I really use it from here, take a look at what needs to be updated, then simply click the update button right from there and let it update. And as you could see, it did it that fast, so it's terrific. Here, Firefox is a typical example where that would never be in your App Store, so it's definitely going to be updated locally. And you could go into Firefox and each of these individual applications and go to the Help menu and click Update, but that would take a lot of time. I find this to be really fast and really good at keeping it updated. So I'll leave you a link in the comments area so you can all download the free version. And this is your Mac tip for the day. So hope you use it. I think it's really going to help you keep your Mac updated. Remember, the updated versions have security updates, so they make your Mac more secure. And sometimes they have great bug fixes. Of course, sometimes the newer versions aren't as good as the older versions, but usually, eventually, the updates catch up and everything goes well. So hope you enjoyed listening. Like the video if you liked it, and join Mac Tips. Subscribe to my channel for lots more Mac tips in the future. Thanks for listening.